all right. I want you to do the best you can at explaining what happened yesterday. Do you think you can do that, Sam?
Must be the captain I'm supposed to meet with.
Yes, I am the captain, and you must be Mr. Mason.
Yes, I am Mr. Mason, and I assume that ship behind you is yours?
Forgive me, I'm getting very old and my memory isn't what it used to be. Why have you chosen my vessel? I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm grateful, but to be fair, my ship has seen better days.
Well, you see, I'm a writer. And the reason I chose your vessel is because you're the only one heading to Dunwich. And I'm seeking that place for inspiration.
Well then, we should get going before it gets dark. It's way harder to travel in the dark with this ship. But anyways, hop on board. I'll show you around.
Alright. Sounds good.
Harold, there's someone I would like you to meet.
Oh, hi. My name is Harold.
It's nice to meet you, Harold. I'm Mason.
Okay. So, if you don't mind me asking, why did you decide to board this vessel? I mean, no offense, Captain, but this ship isn't in the best of shape, so I thought I'd ask.
You see, Mr. Mason here is a writer, and he's heading to Dunwich for inspiration.
Oh, all right. I see. And if you don't mind me asking, what are you writing exactly?
There was an incident back in the waters near Dunwich. Back in the day, they say two seamen got tempted by a siren. A boat washed up 3 weeks later, filled with drowned bodies of the dead. I know, scary.
To be honest, that would actually make a pretty good story. No need to tell me anymore.
Well then, if you two are done talking, I would still like to show you around the ship, Mr. Mason.
Be careful if Captain Anderson doesn't take too well to outsiders.
yeah, we're done.
All right, great. Follow me then.
So, if you don't mind me asking, Harold, how did you become the captain's right-hand man?
Well, that's actually a long story. You see, I once was a captain of my own ship. However, I don't know what it was, but one day, me and my crew were sailing out to a town. Funny enough, it was actually close to Dunwich, but then a heavy storm knocked us over and the whole crew, they were just dead like that. I was just out there all alone when Captain Anderson, he found me, and he saved me.
Wait, the captain found you?
Yeah, he was the one that found me after I told him my situation. He helped me.
So he helped you?
Yeah, he did. He gave me a position as his first-hand man about 4 months later.
Wow. Sounds like the captain is a good man.
He is. God put him on the surf for a reason, and I don't know where I would have been if he wasn't there.
Well, thanks anyways. I'm gonna go back to my room and study.
Oh, all right then. Well, I'll talk to you later, I guess.
Oh, Mr. Mason. Glad to see you up and about. So how did you sleep? Hopefully the beds were comfortable.
Yeah. The bed was fine.
I'm glad to hear it. And hey, I'm sorry about the waves. I know they can be a little crazy.
Don't worry about it. Oh, hey, if I may ask, Harold mentioned that you rescued him. Is that true?
Yeah, I guess I did. I mean, it was the right thing to do. Besides, what was I supposed to do? Just leave him there?
Oh, yeah. I guess that's true. How long ago was that, by the way?
I think it was about a year ago. Yeah, about that long.
All right, thanks for telling me. I'm glad Harold had a good friend that cares for him.
Yeah. Yeah, he's always telling people about how I was sent by God.
Yeah, he mentioned that to me. Hey, is he Catholic or Christian by any chance?
Either Catholic or Christian. I haven't had a chance to ask him that yet. Why, are you religious?
Well, I was raised Catholic, but not that religious. However, I've recently been studying on this God I've heard about from time to time.
Oh, really? What is it?
Well, you see, there's this city called Kingsport, and I don't know exactly what the deal is there. All I know is that they keep hearing people talk about the name of a God they worship. I don't remember exactly what the name of it was, but if memory serves me correct, I believe it's Dagon. But I could be wrong on that. But I've been studying a lot of stuff.
Wait, did you just say Dagon?
Yeah. Does that name have any meaning to you?
Yes. Yes, it does. My mother, she actually used to live in Innsmouth. And she used to worship Dagon.
If I may ask, who or what is Dagon?
Well, to answer that, I'll have to ask you a question. Have you ever heard of the Deep Ones?
The Deep Ones? No, I haven't. Who are they?
The Deep Ones are freaks that live in the ocean. If you hear about them, most people will talk about their appearance.
Why? What's wrong with their appearance?
Well, how do I say this? They look like fish.
Fish? You're serious?
Yes, I'm serious. Their look has been known to be so hideous that you could very well faint just by glancing at them. But that's just a rumor. The Deep Ones worship this creature named Dagon.
Okay, but what is Dagon?
Well, first of all, I'm not the one to be asking that question, and I can only tell you what I know, which isn't much, but Dagon's origins are, as far as I'm aware, unknown. However, from what I know, it seems like he possesses people and turns them into cultists.
Cultists? Are you referring to those ones you call the Deep Ones?
Yeah, I am. And from what I know, in the early stages, they're normal people, but they get driven into madness and eventually evolve into those fish people, eventually worshipping Dagon himself.
Just how powerful is Dagon?
Dagon is the terror of the deep. With one look, you're his.
Captain! Mr. Mason, there's a wave coming!
Calm down, Harold. How big is the wave?
I would say a 90-foot wave.
Harold, go tell Sam to take cover.
Yes, sir. I'll do so right away.
Sam? Who's Sam?
There's no time to explain. Now listen, Mason. Come with me.
Okay, but who's Sam?
Don't ask questions that can be answered later. Follow me or die here. Okay, listen to me very carefully. No one, and I repeat, no one, has ever survived a wave this big. They only ever talk about waves like this one in fairy tales. So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna try and outrun it.
Are you kidding me? We can't outrun that thing.
Do you have a better idea, son? Because if you do, I'd love to hear it.
No, I'm sorry. I'm just...
Well, if you weren't religious before, make sure you say your prayer, son.
Dear God, I know I haven't been close, but please, please, I don't want to die. I promise, if you let us live, I'll do good. Just please don't let us die.
Sam!
Where is... Wait. Captain! Harold! Where are you two?
What happened?
Who are you?
Me. I'm Sam. I stuck on board earlier to travel with my dad to Dunwhich.
You're Sam, okay? Well... Where's your father?
I don't know. One moment I was looking over at my bed, and then...
And then what?
Something took him.
I'm sorry, something took him.
Yeah, I saw something grab him and throw him out the window.
Wait, was there anyone else on board the ship?
No. There was something else in there with us. Or something.
Something?
He didn't look human. He looked like a fish. It was hideous. He just stood there and he threw him out the ship and I didn't do anything. I just screamed and hid. That's when it jumped out. However, it didn't move. I couldn't move and then everything else went blank after that. What was that? That's it!
Wait. We can't just get off the ship.
The hell we can't!
No, listen to me. If we jump down there, there's no saying we'll even be able to get back onto the ship. Plus, what if there's more of them down there? There's no telling we'll even be able to face them.
Would you rather just stay here and die by that thing?
So we face that thing. And kill it.
What do you want from us?
This is my ship, and no one's taking it.
Dad! Dad, you okay? Thank God.
Yes, I'm okay, son. There's no need to worry. I took those things down. Apparently, those things aren't immune to bullets.
Captain, where is Harold?
I don't know. I just woke up on a rock and I had to swim here to help you both, but I'm just glad you both are okay.
Dad, did you see more while coming here?
I did. I saw about six of them swimming towards me. I knew that I couldn't stay on the rock, so I jumped off and swam over here to you guys.
What, does that mean they followed you?
I believe so, and that means we can't stay here for much longer.
Wait. We just can't get off this ship. We don't have anywhere else to go.
I know, but look, if those things come aboard, there's no telling how long we would be able to hold them off for it. Besides, we're not too far off from shore. Look!
Wait, no, we can't go there. When I was out, I had a dream about that exact place. That island, it's a horrible place. That's Innsmouth.
Oh my god. You're right, it's Innsmouth. We can't go there, that place is where evil lives.
Well, it's still a town, guys. I say that now that we know there's a town, we head there. We find a phone or a car and just get the hell out of there before any of them know we were even there.
Look, Mason, I like you, friend, but if you head there, don't expect to come out of that place alive. That place is where more of those fish things live.
We're running out of options here. I agree. We just can't stay here and wait to be picked off by those things. But if we're not heading towards the town, then there's no point in leaving the ship. We need to either go to the town or stay here.
Dad, unfortunately he's right. We can't just leave the ship without going somewhere. I don't want to head towards Innsmouth, but if we do leave the ship, we need to head there. Because otherwise, there's nowhere else to go.
Shit. Okay. We'll head towards Innsmouth. Besides, Mason might be right. There might be a car or a phone that we can use to call for help.
But wait, what about my dream? Are we just going to ignore the fact that I saw the town without even knowing about it in the first place?
We are not ignoring it. It is weird, but we have no other choice. Come on, let's get going.
Hold on. I need to tell you something, Mason. In private. Sam, go see if you can find anything below deck.
Alright.
Mason, if anything happens to me, I want you to take care of my son Sam for me.
What? Why me? You've barely known me for a day.
I know, but I have this feeling that I don't have long. Like I'm not meant to make it out of here, and you're the only one here right now that would be able to take care of him if anything happens to me. So please, I'm asking you, if anything does happen to me, please promise me that I'll take care of him.
I...
Please.
All right. I'll take care of him.
Thank you. Come on. Let's get going.
Captain, what is this place?
I have no idea. Just look around, see if we can find a way out.
What's that? What's that?
I don't know, but I think it's best if we don't know what it is.
Captain Anderson? Are you even listening to me?
He's here.
What? Who's here?
Dakin.
What is wrong with your eyes, Captain?
He's shown me everything. He's shown my true purpose. I will be one with him.
Captain, snap out of it. This isn't you. It's this thing that's controlling you.
Don't you get it, Mason? Dagon is here, and he is beautiful.
Captain, what about your son? Huh? Are you just going to forget about him?
I have no son.
Dad!
Sam. Stay back. Sam, stay back.
What's wrong with my dad? What's wrong with my dad?
That's not your dad in there. I don't know what he is.
Dad, are you okay? Please speak to me.
I am not your father. And I have no son. And you are an outsider.
Your dad, Sam. That was something else. Believe me when I say I'm truly sorry.
I know. We have to get out of here soon. Whatever that was, it'll most definitely try again.
Yeah, you're right. We have to.
Mason? Mason, what are you doing?
Sam! Run!
What?
This isn't you!
No, I will not stop. Dagon has showed me my purpose, and we shall dive down through the abysses. And in that lair of the deep ones, we shall dwell amidst the wonder and glory forever.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Of course you don't. You aren't one with us yet. Oh, but you will be. You will be one with the deep ones.
No, please, please, Mason, don't.
See, they have all come to witness this beautiful sacrifice.
Mason, listen to me. It's Sam.
Yes, I know who you are, Sam. It is with great pleasure that I...
Mason?
It's in me. He's in me, Sam. Please, run.
No! You leave Mason alone!
Get out of my head!
No. You leave Mason alone! Mason, behind you!
It's for Captain Anderson, you bastard! You need to destroy that place. It is not safe. You need to destroy that place.
I can't promise you that, but we'll do what we can. Okay, Mason?
Okay. Thank you. So, can I go now?
Yeah. You can go. I think I asked you all the questions.
Okay. Thank you again. Hey, may I ask, where's Sam?
Oh, he should be done in just a second. He should be the last door to the left.
Are you all right?
Yeah, I think so.
Hey, sorry for what happened out there. Your father, he was a good man. I'll make sure to tell his story.
What do you mean you're gonna write a story?
You said on the way to the station that he helped a lot of people in his life. I want people to know about the things he's done with his life.
Thank you.
Hey, I'll make sure nothing happens to you, Sam. You're gonna be okay.
Town.